Recently, the Channel 4 programme Hollyoaks has run a storyline with a 12-year-old child questioning her, and I can't help but roll my eyes to heaven when I say this, their gender identity. In any healthy society, a girl who thinks they are a boy, or a boy who thinks they are a girl, would be quickly told that such thoughts are nonsense, and a person is unable to change their gender. Anyone born with only a penis and testicles will always be a boy or a man, and anyone who is born only with a fanny will always be a girl and a woman. This has been the case throughout all of human history. But in the past few years, a fringe extremist group of people have promoted the ideology that gender is a social construct, and people may be born in the wrong bodies. This is, of course, rubbish. A man cannot become a woman, and a woman cannot become a man. No more than a white man cannot become a black man, or a black man become a white man. The self-identification ideology, where anyone can be whatever they want to be, and no one can question it, was largely ignored and somewhat entertained for some years. This was when it was just adults stating these things to other adults. It could be easily argued that wider society has been far too tolerant of such groups, and there has not been enough opposition or pushback on such stances. Even so-called controversial commentators such as Piers Morgan have gone along with this ridiculous stance, only opposing such measures when it came to men participating in women's sports, or men going into women's jails. However, the time for ignoring people who promote this ideology has now passed. This is because these groups are actively and unashamedly promoting this degenerate ideology onto children. Let's have a look at this Hollyoaks clip now.
Okay, just take it one step at a time.
I don't know what the first step is. I'm a boy, but my body's all wrong, and how am I supposed to tell my parents?
I'll help you in whatever way I can. But you need to know that your life is in your hands. So stop bunking off school. And then, and only then, you can start thinking about how and when you can tell your mum. Rose, you can't move on with your life until you've told the people you love who you truly are. That is, if you're sure.
I'm so sure.
Well, then, once you've taken the first step, you can start actually being who you truly are. It's the best feeling in the world.
Yes, children, whose society rightly deems are too young to get tattoos, drink alcohol, smoke cigarettes, watch certain films at the cinema, and something as simple as putting a cross in a box to vote in an election, and now being told they are old enough and mature enough to take puberty blockers and completely change their growth and development for the worse. In this story, we have an adult advising a child that their perceived thoughts about being a boy are completely valid, and that she should tell her parents. Before I continue, if you enjoy this vid, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel. It makes a huge difference for small channels such as mine. Children have only begun to believe these false gender-changing stories in recent years, due to its promotion in TV shows, the media, social media, and other means. This includes corporate companies such as Costa Coffee, who last year advertised their product with a so-called trans man with a double mastectomy, which is basically an advert of a woman who has cut off her breasts in an irreversible surgery. Such images can be found in articles and on social media online, and they look absolutely horrific. And it genuinely saddens me each time I see them. I consider the person who has done untold damage to their bodies in the pursuit of happiness, when this was so unnecessary and wrong. Some young women today have had this surgery done, and young men have had the equivalent damaging surgery done, to make them appear as though they are women. This is a recent, completely unnatural phenomenon that needs to be stopped. If there is anyone watching this who is considering making life-altering surgery to change their gender, or if there are parents who have children who have spoken to them about this, do not allow this to happen. The life-altering changes to the bodies will almost certainly not make them feel any happier. That's not my opinion. That's the view of all London, a man who has had over 30 surgeries to appear as a woman, but has since seen the light, rejected this ideology, and become a Christian. It is a shame on British and Western society in general that there has been so little opposition to this evil. I miss the day when soaps were still trash, but they did not have the political and woke promotion that infects TV today.
After everything you say, do I? No, you can't tell me what to do, you ain't my mother! Yes, I am!
And this clearly includes Hollyoaks. This is a TV show on at 7 p.m, which is way before the watershed. Who knows the damage this story is having on other confused young children? For those still watching, thank you for sticking with me. There are a couple of easy things you can do to fight back in a little way against this madness. Firstly, boycott Hollyoaks. Do not give the program your time and get its viewing numbers down as low as possible. But more importantly, complain to Ofcom. I will include a link in the description to this video and how to complain about the program. If no one complains, nothing will change. Many thanks for listening. Bye.